श्रीमान् वेङ्कटनाथार्य कवितार्किकेसरी वेदान्ताचारवर्यो मे सन्निधत्तां सदा हृदि. सो ऑन दिस ग्रेट ग्रैंड अकेशन ऑफ स्वामी देसिका 750th बर्थ एनिवर्सरी वी आर एंजॉयिंग श्रीमद् वेदांत देसिक विषयक स्तोत्रमाला स्वामी देसिकन्स ग्लोरियस वैभवम अवतारम एंड हिस् auspicious attributes, Kalyana Gunas, all these are talked about, praised in several stotrams by Swami Trikumarar, illustrious son, Nayanaracharya, through Pillayandadi, Desika Prabhati, Desika Vigraha Dhyanam, Desika Mangalam, Desika Dinacharya, all that. We also enjoyed about Prativadi Bhayangaram Annan's Saptati Ratnamalika in a summary form. We enjoyed Acharya Avatara Kattartha by Brahmatantra Swatantra Swami, Mundram Patam, third Patam, as well as yesterday we enjoyed Vedanta Desika Gadhyam. Now, today we will enjoy in summary form Kandadai Mannappangar's Desika Nootrandadi, which one day we will have to enjoy verse by verse because it is so beautiful and deep, full of Acharya Bhakti in the lines of Ramanuja Nootrandadi or Kanninan Sirithambu or even Pillayandadi. That reminds me, Swami Desikan's son has composed Pillayandadi as well, and we have not touched upon that, which we will take it up from next week. So this particular Desika Nootrandadi was composed by Kandadai Mannappangar, and Kandadai Mannappangar Swami is the Shishya of Kumara Vardacharyar, Nayanaracharyar, Swami Desikan's son. And once Swami Desikan was in Srirangam, he was sitting in the front corridor of his house, going through the various works, and he was deeply contemplating on the depth of the work. And probably there was one Kandadai Lakshmanacharyar, another Acharya Purushar, along with his Shishyas, were walking in the street in front of Swami Desikan's Sannidhi. And when Swami Desikan didn't get distracted by the happenings in the street, and he was fully immersed in the Grantham, so he failed to notice Acharya walking. So he didn't get up because he didn't see. And one of the Shishyas who was walking behind the Acharya noticed it and found that Swami Desikan is committing Acharya Apacharam, Bhagavata Apacharam, and hence he was enraged by Desikan's indifference or not ignore, or he thought Desikan had ignored his Acharya Kandadai Lakshmanacharya. So that Shishya, after the Acharya had passed, came to Desikan's Sannidhi, Desikan's house, and pulled his leg with anger, because he had shown disrespect to his Acharya. So Swami Desikan realized that he had committed Apacharam, and he sought forgiveness from the Bhagavata Apacharam that he had committed. And he felt so hurt and that he had committed Bhagavata Apacharam. He had left that place and shifted to Karnataka, Satyamangalam village afterwards, Swami Desikan along with his family. So our Kandadai Lakshmanacharya was not at all aware of all these things. And after a few years, Kandadai Lakshmanacharya, Acharya Purushar, had some illness in his body, and he had no child blessing as well. He was not blessed with a child. Putra Bhagyam didn't happen. So probably his spouse had heard through one of the Shishyas, and she had thought that this is a Bhagavata Pacharam on Swami Desikan himself, and that's why probably he had left. And when she informed her husband, Swami Kandadai Lakshmanacharya, they both realized that they need to seek forgiveness from Swami Desikan. So they went to Satyamangalam, and they were there with Swami Desikan for a year, performed Acharya Kaikariyam to Swami Desikan, and consumed Sripada Tirtham from Swami Desikan's padukas, and after that the illness got cured. They were blessed with a child, and he is called Tirthapillai because of the Tirtham from Swami Desikan's padukas. He is called Tirthapillai, and that Tirthapillai, it appears, is none other than Kandadai Mannappangar, who is a Shishya of Kumara Varadacharya, who has composed this Vedanta Desikan Nutrandadi. Desikan Nutrandadi consists of 100 verses, as it is Nutrandadi. It is in Andadi style. The one verse ends with a word, and the next verse starts off with the same word. Similar to Kanninun Chiritambu or Ramanuja Nutrandadi or Pillayandadi. This talks about Swami Desikan's glories, Swami Desikan's Kalyana Gunas, Swami Desika Bhakta's greatness, Swami Desikan Bhakti, Acharya Bhakti, how much, what all fruits it would yield to us, and Swami Desikan's Sri Suktis, his Grantham's Mahima, and our duty as a Swami Desika Bhaktas, what are they? All these things are talked about. And Swami Desikan, in order to save the community, in order to save the humanity, in order to save the world, Perumal himself has appeared as Swami Desikan. He is the Vishnu Kanthavataram. He is the very amsam of Trimalai Srinivasan. He is the avataram of Swami Emberumanar himself. Like that, the greatness of Swami Desika is talked about in this verse, in these verses. And Swami Desikan's Kalyana Gunas are numerous, infinite. He always does good to anyone and everyone, regardless of their enmity or friendship towards him. He has, and regardless of their status, their position, their birth, because of the vatsalyam on others, he blesses and showers his daya on all those who take refuge at his Swami Desikan's lotus feet. Because of this natural kripai, he behaves in a sarvavida bandhu to his disciples, shishyas, abhimanis, bhaktas. He grants the paramapadam itself through initiation, upadesams, granthams, dhayai, and his own vatsalya. And he is sarvatantra swatantra. He can do anything and everything and under the earth. Swami Desikan's greatness is very beautifully described in this Nutrandadi. And not only that, there is a greatness and vaibhavam on Swami Desika Bhaktas themselves. Desika Bhaktas are called Vedantic scholars. They shine with divine knowledge and the right jnana. And it is best to hold on to Swami Desika Bhaktas, their lotus feet, and they themselves would be able to save us. And it is better to mingle with them, satsangatse nitsangatvam. So by getting into the association of Desika Bhaktas, we can get saved and without fail. And the fruits that we have by getting involved in Swami Desika is, we get rid of all the fears, we get rid of samsaric afflictions, we get rid of future birth, death, life cycles, no more births, and we get all ihapara phalan, and we get all wealth, and ultimately we will be able to attain moksham and perform eternal kaikaryam at Sri Vaikuntham, and it gives us complete bliss and peranandam. It gives us happiness, and it does not take us on a wrong path. We would never ever get away from the right track, concrete path, well laid out by acharyas, purvacharyas, because Swami Desikan has established all these concrete, beautiful road built in with both sides the fences, so nobody else can interrupt our path. Swami Desikan's Grantham's greatness is, we will be able to get undiluted, unpolluted, unalloyed, and uncorrupted jnanam about Vedantams, about Alvas Divya Prabandhams. We will be able to get Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksham, Chaturvida Purusharthams. We, by Anusandhanam or Swami Desika Stotrams, Granthams, Ragasya Granthams, or any work, we are able to get rid of all our papams and the vicious cycles of samsara tapam, and we can get paramapadam, we can get vairagyam, that nadevam desikat param, and we would get to know who is paradevata, and on its own accord we will be able to get the right jnana just by contemplating on Swami Desika's Divya Mangalaha Vigraha and by associating ourselves with the Desika Bhaktas. And what's the duty of us as Vedanta Desika Bhaktas? It is to involve ourselves in Mano, Vak, Kaya, body, speech and mind, body, speech and walk. So we are by contemplating on Swami Desika's works, Swami Desika's Divya Mangalaha Dhyanam, by praising him openly through our tongue, Swami Desikan's stotrams, by reciting his stotrams, by reciting the stotrams on Swami Desikan, by performing the kaikaryam through our body, for all these Swami Desika's 750th birth anniversary, by contributing our mind, by taking part physically in the various utsavams, and that's the blessing that we have, we are bequeathed with, we have performed so much punya, and only such bhagyasalis will be able to get such a blessing. And Swami Desikan's glories, vaibhavam, we should always utter in praise of him through vayinal padi manathinal sindhika poya pilayum pugadaruvan nindranavum thiyinil dusagum. By uttering his praise, by singing in praise of him, by contemplating his vaibhavams, and by offering flowers at his acharya padukas, by enjoying his divine tirumeni, and by listening to his wonderful works through acharyas, Vedantic scholars in their upanyasams, by following the Bhagavatas, Desika Bhaktas, being with them in a friendly manner, in a cordial manner, without any mutual hatred or enmity. Thus, we will be able to get ultimate bliss in this world as well as in the upper world in Sri Vaikuntham. And Vedanta Desika is the Acharya for the entire Sri Vaishnava community in Sri Bhashyam. It is he who had blessed us from the Sri, he comes in the Sri Bhashya Parampara from Ramanuja, and Vedanta Desika had blessed us through Kumara Varadacharyar to the entire Sri Vaishnava community, the Sri Bhashyam. And thus, even if we have not studied Sri Bhashyam in a traditional manner from an Acharya, we should rush to our Acharyan, Pragritam Acharyan, and learn at least the Mangala Slokam of Sri Bhashyam, Akila Bhuvana Janmaste Mapangadi Lile, through Acharya Sri Suktis, and thus be blessed to receive the Dhyay of Swami Desika. Acharyan Trivadigale Sharanam, Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline, Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha, Srimate Nigamanta Mahadesikaya Namaha, Namo Narayana, Adiyan.